Petaluma Radio Players.
Like talking on
air. And now, the Petaluma Radio Players, located just north of the Golden Gate Bridge in Northern California's Sonoma County, bring you another provocative radio drama from their home on KPCA FM 103.3 and via the World Wide Web on KPCA FM. Our drama during this week's presentation is a comedy of chilling proportions. Join us now for part one of The Misadventure of the Disobliging Cadaver by Vince Stadon, and featuring world-famous sleuth Sherlock Holmes and his trusty cohort in crime-solving Dr. Watson. Who hid the body? Whose body is hidden? And why should we care? Find out next when the Petaluma Radio Players present the first in our series of Sherlock Holmes comedies, Who Knew Murder Could Be So Much Fun?
Exterior, Ascot Racecourse, Berkshire, summer 1895.
He's not here, Professor Moriarty. Been waiting all morning, not a peep. Likely he's too scared to show his face.
Quiet now. I have 100 guineas on ill repute, and she's a length ahead of the field. A wonderful horse, Mr. Dial. A quite exceptional animal. I do hope you've a shilling or two on her.
I'm not a gambler, Professor.
Ah, neither am I, Mr. Dial. Luck is for fools. I only stake my money on a sure thing. You see, there was never any doubt. And once again, I find myself ahead of Scotland Yard. So, Mr. Dial, Slater hasn't shown. I suspected he wouldn't. This is an opportunity, Mr. Dial, for you to once again demonstrate to me your remarkable talents. I have never met anybody who relishes the act of killing as much as you do. Spread the word. Let Ned Slater know that the sword of Damocles hangs over his head. Instill fear into his wretched heart. And then, when he is suffering his night terrors, drop the sword on his head.
I shall see to it, Professor.
And Mr. Dial, if you ever say my name out loud again, I shall have you fed to the horses in tiny, tiny little morsels mixed in with their oats. Now, I must collect my winnings.
Interior, Jolly Nobbing Public House, night.
Pint, Bess. Got a thirst on me.
Reckon you always got a thirsty gullet, Ned Slater, but I want to see your pennies first.
Yeah, woman. The last of it. Enough to sweeten my frown, I reckon.
Surprised to see you show your face in here, truth be told. Not after what I've heard.
What do you mean?
Whispers? Rumours? Someone wants you dead, Ned Slater. Fella by the name of Dial, I heard.
Dial?
As I said, whispers. Rumours. Ned Slater, you gone the colour of snow. Really now, big strong fella like you? Good riddance to ya.
Interior, Victoria train station. Early evening.
Over here.
Ah, there you are, my dear. Such a dutiful daughter. You really shouldn't have gone to the trouble of meeting me, my dear. I'm quite capable, and you must have so many things to occupy your time.
Nonsense. I always have time to greet my father and welcome him home to London. You must be tired and hungry from the journey.
Good Lord!
Father, what is it?
That man. He looks... His face.
Man? What man?
He's gone. But he was there on the platform staring at me, and he looked... Oh, it doesn't matter, my dear. As you said, I'm tired and hungry.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.